All right, here we go again, Dark Age of Camelot. Welcome, everyone, to the realm of Hibernia. Right now I'm in Magmel. It's a little town. I guess it's one of the beginner towns. I got levels 10 through 14 quests here. I finished a bunch of them, but I think now I'm going to go to the battleground. So I'm going to talk to Channeler Gavin. And you hit click battleground here, and I think he just takes you to the appropriate one for your level. I think each battleground, it goes in 10 levels each, like, you know, 1 to 10, 11 to 20. If I remember, if that's correct, I'm not exactly sure, but I think that's how it works. So my last time on, I did a battleground shortly before the server restart. And it was 1 through 10. This should be the Hills of Claret. I don't know if this is the same one or not. Captain Delvin. The Dauntless is not for everyone. Okay, this is the same as I got last time. He's just going to give me a whole bunch of quests here. To fight creatures and monsters and maybe even enemies of the realm. Decimate the Scrag population. The window's messed up or something, but I can't read beyond. Venture into harm's way and defeat the following. I can't see what's next. Capricious beings. And this one is goblins. I don't know what the battleground deserter is. It was bad enough when our only enemies were from distant realms. Now we face deserters and their underlings from within our own ranks. Go and destroy the deserter underlings. As undisturbed, they will surely grow in power. But he was purple. Does that mean it's going to be a very hard quest? Let's try. They're all 10 through 14. I won't forget the realm enhancement. I think she gives me some buffs. Oh yeah, look at all these buffs. Increased target strength. Increased constitution. Increased dexterity. Increased strength and constitution. Increased quickness. And it goes on. The printer just came on and scared the crap out of me. The hastener is a tree. Thank you, sir. All right, off we go into the battleground. I'm going to work my way from closest out to furthest. Closest is on the back end of the lake here. I don't see any mobs. Maybe they're in the water. Here are the goblins. So that's my pet, the forest compatriot. Oh, I moved. That's just as well, because I actually wanted a turret there. The Forest Emissary is the turret. Why did the goblin... Oh, because he just spawned. I thought the green goblin warrior turned... Oh crap, I better put my pet quick. That wasn't the pet, that was another turret. Quick, cast it! This is what I've been doing. Spacing them out just about like this. Put my pet kind of in the middle with all the forest hearts, which are the turrets around it. And then I usually put a buffer, vent of physical resistance, grants increase to resistance, body, spirit, and energy. I run out of, what do we call it here? Energy, mana, whatever you call the yellow bar. That's my resource. I tend to run out of that pretty quickly. Uh-oh. Okay, they're good guys. These are all good guys. Should I go with them? Doing RVR stuff. This guy has like no consideration of camps. He's obviously a new player. They don't last long. Maybe a minute, minute and a half. Grove Shield is armor factor increase by 71 on me. Grove's Anguish I could put on my pet, I think. And yeah, that the target deals 1.5 energy damage to enemies that hit them with a melee attack. So I could actually put on everything, but I really have to conserve my mana. And like these goblins are spawning too far away, so I'm going to have to pull them, which is going to spend even more of my mana. You don't move very fast in water. Forces of Albion, led by Grablas, have captured Kyr Claret. There is PvP going on here, because Minda was just killed by Stabby Keen. Really should keep a lookout. Oh, another animist. That's a bard. Dolby was just killed by Stabby Keen. Well, I've got to admit, it's not the most engaging gameplay, but I've talked about it before in one of my recordings that I kind of like a simple playstyle. Well, this is kind of it, I think. There's really not a whole lot to this. You're putting out your army of turrets and your pet. You make sure they're kept up enough so that you don't get overrun. And then you let them do their work. Look how quick this dies. That's a blue. I did some reading after my first playthrough, which was... I was so confused at first. People have said that their animist has actually died in PvP. Who's coming here? They've died in PvP, and their army of mushrooms killed their attackers. Kind of funny. My map disappeared. Visibility is not great. I wonder if I could fix that. Everything is kind of on max. It's just an old game. Spirit of aggravation. That's what that spell was. She's a bard. Do you need these? If she does, I'd be happy to invite her. Oh, that's it. 10 out of 10. So, release clump is going to get rid of all my turrets. And release is going to get rid of my pet. Now I'm on my own for the next quest, which isn't far. I'm going to go down on the other side of the lake, I guess. I have a quest right outside of the Midgard Keep. Do I need Scrags? Is that what the quest is here? These are named. Zephyrs and Chief Mulgok, those are named. Capricious Wisps. I did the Goblin problem. Deserter Underlings. Yeah, I need Scrags. I'll do these right now. But now this is going to be a little tricky here, because if I set up my turrets too close, it'll pull them all. I've had that happen to me while I was learning how to play an Animist. So, I guess what I'll do then is I'll set up like way beyond where I think they're going to pull, and they'll sit there obviously because they'll be out of range, but then when they expire I'll just move them up a little bit. I'll keep inching up and I'll pull on my own in the meantime. I'm only level 14, so Forest Compatriot and the Forest Emissaries are my mushroom armies. Surprise, right and left mouse button doesn't make your character move forward. I thought it did. Did I not cast? I thought I cast on one of those. Maybe I moved before it finished casting and I interrupted myself. All clumped up. That's the spirit of aggravation. Love the names. It definitely aggravated that Scrag. So I know I'm too far now. I'm going to move them up just a little bit. Like, just out of range would be perfect, because if I move them into range, it'll pull them all at once. And that's no fun for me. Let's see, I would rather be sitting and resting and getting my mana back instead of having to pull. Is that? I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little anxious here now. The biggest problem is when I pull and when I run out and pull, these things expiring while I'm out here pulling like that. And then I get back and all that's left is my pet. Which my pet might be enough to kill one of these anyway. But if it doesn't grab aggro, I'm probably gonna get hurt or killed. See, that just happened. This is just my pet here. Quick cast a turret. Get a blue one. The root works, but as soon as I take damage, it breaks the root. Just wanted to test it out. I have a root called Ripening Vines, and then I also have a turret that roots. Hey, I'm in a group. Cast the Briar Shower. which is an AoE spell that my pet casts. Okay, that's it. We'll clump them and release them. Unless they need more. Oh, it's group, not party. Where do I set UI everything so small? Oh, I know how to do that. Grab mouse at top left, control left, click, and move, I think. I don't want to try it because I have my UI and everything set exactly how I want right now. I think I've already done it. Oh, this will be interesting. I don't know how I'm going to be in a party. Unless we set a camp. Like, I'm kind of stationary with my mushrooms. I can't really move around unless I keep recasting, and then I'm just going to be out of mana. So I guess let's just continue doing this. I'm going to move it up. Remember that was frustrating when I first started back into Dark Age, trying to figure out the UI, and everything was tiny. It's so annoying, they move out of range. I got four of them here. It's AoE, AoE, AoE. Watch them all fall. It's awesome. I mean, how is that fair? Oh, there's one on here. And we're on the move. They need goblins. would like to know if my pet, I mean, I'm pretty sure it does take experience from the group. But I'd like to know how much. Not sure if these players know where they want to go. I know one of them said they just want to get experience and learn how to set their UI. That's fair enough. Need more mobs. I mean, you can't really get as many mobs as those scrags were, all in a heap. Oh, I need the capricious wisp. I need these. Player. Cool. You gained a realm, you gained 3 realm points. Yeah, that was a player. I hate running through the water. You go so slow. Clump. This can get annoying. What is little brat? Little brat is a mentalist, and the Magicka. What is she? She's a bard. That's the central keep, care, claret, I guess. I'm gonna sit down in this water. You know, honestly, I don't think my character cares. She's like part vegetation. settings for the interface. Interface elements, this isn't what she's looking for. In-game options, this is not what she's looking for. If she wants to adjust her resolution, she has to do it from the title page. There's a bar with the buttons for inventory. What's happening here? Is that a mid? That's a Midgard troll, isn't it? This is Midgard over here. I better put up more stuff. Killed momentarily. There's a Briton. Yeah. Let's go. They're gonna come around and try to cut us off. Britain this way. Well, I'm not going down without a fight. Let's cast. It's my pet. Two shot. How many did I complete? Two quests completed, that's good. And I got level 15. Better to be in the water, I think. She can't figure out how to do the interface. Now I'm curious now, and I think I want to try. Oh yeah, I just did it. I did. It's exactly like I told her. Click and hold, left mouse button, and then J. drag, and it will resize your screen. I kind of want to go out and fight. That group was bigger than us, though. And there was a Briton mixed in with a mid, so like there's a three-way fight out there, actually. It'd be fun. Did they already go out? I want my buffs. No wonder. I don't think that Imagica speaks English. It is such a relaxing PvP experience, as opposed to Albion Online, where every time I die, I lose all my stuff. This is just fun. You know what? I'm going out there. I'm not going to stay in this castle while there's PvP to be done. Or are they? Let's just follow people. Look how cool that is. There are Hibernians running around in the lake again. I guess they're in there for the quest. I feel like if I don't have my pet and at least a couple of turrets out, I'm totally defenseless. Could I cast Grove's Shield on somebody else? No. But I could cast Grove's Anguish on somebody else. How many of these things I can put out at once? This is 7. 8. I have eight pets out here. 7 including my pet. 7 turrets and my pet. Can we invite him? Oh, that's another animist. Cool. Where was the are we full? Is 4 people the limit for a group? Thank you. And we're on the move again. I think a magic guy is German because somebody is translating. I think that's either German or like Norwegian. And I know that he just said old school. Because it's spelled just like old school with an E at the end. I kind of feel useless without my pets. Like, what do? Just cast my direct damage spells, I guess. I can do a little bit of crowd control. I have a root. This animus just puts them all on top of each other. Have to keep the marker on the ground for the last second after it's cast, otherwise it casts on the new mark that you put down. I'm gonna surround this guy's mushrooms with my mushrooms. Briar shower. Well, you know, I didn't learn any of my new spells, and I got some too. And I didn't train. I'm doing that right now. Wait, who's this? Enemies. That was an enemy. I'm gonna root him. No! Uh-oh, someone behind us. That's a lesson to be learned. Never get far away from your mushrooms. He was able to shoot me with his bow, but then once he tried to backstab me, he got in range of the forest hearts and my forest compatriot, and they killed him. This is a perfect class for me. No skill. Just put out a lot of stuff. This is crazy. Let's see who killed me. One shot right there. I was hit for 117 damage. No, that wasn't one shot. I was hit for 74 damage before that. So, they get me with the bow. That's what I did when I first started to play Dark Age. I was an infiltrator, and I would just go invisible, sneak up on people, kill them with the bow. Then I would usually die. Oh, I'm not even in the battleground anymore, huh? Am I in Tir na n'og? I am. I might as well sell whatever I got. I got some stuff. This hat's better than mine. These gloves are better than mine, too. I don't even look at the stats anymore. And leggings, yellow leggings, sure. The rest I'll sell. Oh, it's sell. Can't sell to this merchant. Is there a channeler in here? I need to see the healer. I have res sickness. Resurrection illness. Reduces damage and concentration by 50%. There's a channeler in here. Okay, I'm in a different battleground now. Killalo. Maybe it goes by levels of 5 instead of 10 like I thought. That's why it booted me to Tir na n'og, because I was too high a level that for that battleground. I guess I need to get out of my group then to disband. I'm not sure, is there a merchant that will take the stuff that I got? I have plenty of bag space, I don't think it matters. Want this? Oh, she'll take that. I don't know what rusty tinderbox is, and trinkets of the hills of Claret. I'm gonna keep that for now. If it's resources for crafting, I'll just put it in the guild stores. I don't know if I want to go out there solo, but this is a different battleground. I may not be as active. But I think I'm going to call it here anyway. I never got to train, did I? 12 arboreal and 6 verdant. If I train verdant, I get a wood spirit sheath. It's a pet. Oh no, it's a absorbing bubble. Creates a bubble that absorbs the damage of a single melee hit. Not interested in that. I don't know why it goes to 50 like that. If I get arboreal, I can only train once, but my next skill there is Circle of Anger. It's my next pet. So let me train that. Train. And then what I didn't do last time, well, there are players here now. I didn't set my new spells. But I'm going to do that later. Thanks for stopping in. Anyone who is interested in Dark Age and would like to play on the Eden Free Shard, it's pretty populated. I'm always seeing players around, and if you've never played, it's, I guess, a great time to get into the game. And if you're like me and you played a long time ago and you wanted to get back into it, it feels like it did years ago. But not so much because I'm like a noob again, getting to learn the game. But there are helpful people that are really helping me learn faster. So there's that too. All right, well, have a nice day.